Gitlam's path of Homer Smith, Achel's follow all Prosper's lava. Glitzel pass far equal. My dear ones, my Wilmot name is Gitlam's path. My other name is Eddie Gardner, president of the Wild Salmon Defenders Alliance, also a member of this village, this community here, Squaw. And it's a pleasure to see all of you answer this call to come and drum and sing and pray for the sacred waters and for our sacred salmon. In harmony with thousands of others around the world who are doing this work. This is really good. We must never ever underestimate the power and the energy that is stirred and released when we pray and put our good intentions out to where it's needed the most. And water is life, is a call to action by the people at Standing Rock. The Sioux people in that territory have stood up against formidable odds, against brutality, to protect our sacred waters. That kind of action, unfortunately, has been needed to protect human rights throughout history. And it will continue into the future, but it is becoming more critical all the time that people take a stand for human rights, for the rights of our Mother Earth, for the rights of our salmon. Because we are not the only species that has a right to be here. All the salmon, the four-legged, the ones that swim, the ones that fly, the rooted ones, they all have a right to be here. Biodiversity is what we depend on. And that's what the salmon represent, biodiversity, because they support so many other living species. As they make their cycles from the headwaters down to the big water and all the way back again to spawn to renew the cycles. We know this. I know that people are becoming more alarmed and more concerned. The red flags are being raised all over the place. That water in this planet of ours, this blue dot that David Suzuki talks about, is in crisis right now. Because we have a lot of shrinking drinking water that is going on right now. And we know that it is happening right here in Canada, where a lot of people believe that we have such a great abundance of water here in Canada. But it's being, as we speak, as we stand here, it's being desecrated. Much of our water is being desecrated through fracking, through fish farms, through big oil, through mining. All of those are human activities. And we must pray that we have the courage to stand up like those people in Standing Rock, to stand up for like those people in Unistot'en, to build a little village in front and block, you know, what is coming, like they're doing at Unistot'en and at Lelu Island. LNG and fracking. Water is life. Water is our common heritage. Water is a public trust. Water is not only a right, for a human right, but it is also a responsibility. It's a responsibility that each and every one of us carries. Nobody is absent from that responsibility to do what is right, to save the waters. Because we are doing this not only for ourselves, we're doing this for all the ones in the natural world, and we're doing this for future generations that are going to depend on what we do. What happens over the next few decades is going to depend on what we do today. And so this call to action, this call to prayer, this call to reverence, you know, for our sacred waters is really important. And so when we sing these sacred songs, we're going to have it and hold in our hearts what is precious and life-giving. Our wild salmon need nice clean water and a nice clean home. We take for granted sometimes water. That old expression that you don't miss the water until the well runs dry is so true, and it's becoming more true all the time. Even here in Chilliwack, there was one time you could turn the tap on and you didn't have to worry about chlorine. Mm-hmm. Now we have to worry about chlorine. And we have to filter our water now, you know, so that we can have drink water and not be poisoned by that chemical. There's pollution that's going on with the agriculture. There's chemical-ridden fertilizers and pesticides that are in there. And that seeps into the aquifer, it seeps into a river. And so we need to have the courage to call on this and say this needs to be changed. You know, the challenges that we face, you know, when we look at the water crisis that's happening here in our territory and around the world, can be quite daunting and overwhelming. But it's our prayers that keep us strong. It's our belief that we can make a difference. It's our belief that we have helpers, not only in the seen world, but the unseen world as well. We need to look to the ancestors. We need to look to our great mother of creation for guidance and strength and wisdom to do our own part. And I was sharing in other circles that generosity and gratitude are two powerful medicines, you know, that we need to use. Gratitude. We can have gratitude and abundance right in our hearts here. It's there. We need to show that gratitude every day, you know, for what we have left. Because what we're doing when we come together like this is putting our minds and our hearts to what we have left that is precious and life-giving and protected, to renew whatever we can do without being overwhelmed. Because we had, with the Wild Salmon Defenders Alliance, when we go out there and do the work that we do, we make sure that we do it with joy in our hearts. That's the energy that keeps us going. That joy that we're doing something meaningful is the medicine that we need to keep us going. And so that's what we're going to do today. We're going to sing. We're going to pray. You know, with joy in our hearts that yes, when we walk away from this drum circle, we'll know that we're in harmony with millions around the world who are trying to do the same thing that we are doing. It's to protect the sacred waters. Water is life. Water is sacred. Water is our common heritage. And water is a human right. Awesome. We're going to begin. This part of our history in this community. We came together today, and we know that behind each and every one of us, there are those two great lineages, one on our mother's and one on our father's side. And they go way back. When we pray and we sing these sacred songs, call the ancestors and the helping spirits to come and be with us, to surround us with their love, to surround us with their support and guidance and wisdom. Each and every one of us who stands around the circle here today also have many friends and relatives behind us who are living in this realm right now. They wish they could be here, but they can't meet for whatever reason. So we're not alone, we're far from alone. Let's feel that strength. There's very much strength and power in numbers. We must really realize that. And when there is a call to action, be there when you can. Don't feel guilty if you can't show up, but just be there when you can. And do the little things. Every little thing counts to protect and preserve and respect and honor what sustains our life. Voicea. We'll sing the Eagle Vision song. Thank you.